Hello, my name is David Luckenbaugh. I'm a statistician with the Office of Equity, Diversity, and Inclusion in the Office of the Director at NIH. I want to welcome you here for a conversation about measurement validity in clinical research. Our objective today is to try to enhance understanding of the key principle of validity for clinical research. So imagine a lot of people do this first thing in the morning. Some people do it in the afternoon. You might hop on a treadmill. Maybe you just go out running. But there's a lot of ways that you can think about what's happening with what you're doing. You could think about the time. How long have you spent running or walking or doing what you're doing? How long have you run? How fast have you gone? How many calories have you burned? All of these are different ways of thinking about performance. So with performance, we can talk about performance as a construct. A construct is a theoretical concept. In looking at the measurement we just talked about, performance in running or in walking, the theoretical concept could be, in fact, performance. But you have to decide what your measurement is going to be. Your measurement is some way in which you can look at that theoretical concept. So if performance is what you're interested in, or speed is what you're interested in, you can develop a measure of speed. On a treadmill, it measures it for you, so it's really easy to do that. So your operational definition for speed could be whatever the measure is that's shown on your treadmill. For distance, it could be the amount of miles that you ran. So then if you were studying the speed that somebody ran, then that would be your operational definition for your construct of performance. So in depression research, there's a lot of different questionnaire scales that can be used, one of which is a Hamilton depression scale. Another one's the Beck depression inventory. Both of these scales are used fairly commonly, but despite the fact that they both measure depression, they're different kinds of measurements. The Hamilton Depression Rating Scale, for example, is measured by clinicians. Clinicians talk to a patient, get a sense of them, and then give ratings on individual symptoms. The Beck Depression Inventory actually is an inventory that is given to the patients, and the patients make the ratings. Sometimes it's guided, where nurses will help the patients to get through the inventory. But despite that, the patients are making the actual ratings. So you have two measures here with slightly different ways of handling a construct like depression. I worked with an interesting group who was working on tremor, and one thing that they had is they had a seashell type shape that they had people trace. And my understanding is that this was a common rating in tremor research. And what happened is that they measured the degree that you went off of this seashell line. So the measurement was the degree, the amount that you went off of the line over a period of time of trying to trace the spiral. So then they thought, well, this may not be the most efficient process. So they develop a computer algorithm to actually measure the trace. So you're getting essentially the same kind of measure, the degree that the line misses the spiral, but it's now a computer-generated algorithm that can be much more sensitive to different properties of the shape. If you're looking at heart disease, you might look at heart attacks or cholesterol, maybe C-reactive protein, or all different things you could use as operational definitions of the construct of heart disease. So what is validity? How well does a measure reflect the construct is what validity is. So validity is not so much balls falling in the same place, but actually them hitting the target. So you have your target is your measurement, your operational definition. So if you look at this, you have a very valid measure as you're hitting the target on the left. In the middle, you have a bunch of balls that look like only one hits the target, so one may be valid. But if you took the average of those distances from the center, you actually might get something that's fairly valid, even though the balls look like they're all over the place. In the third circle on the right, what you see is a bunch of balls that are in a similar location, but all of them are off from the center. So that means this, the items that you have for this would be invalid, because they're not hitting the target. There's several different types of validity that we want to talk about. One is construct validity. This is making sure that you're looking at the same construct, just like I mentioned, tremor and a number of different ways of measuring that. You can have face validity. Face validity is a subset of construct validity where basically you read the questions, and if they sound like they fit the construct, then we assume that they do. So it's a very simple, kind of intuitive measure of construct validity. Content validity, however, is when the items in a set seem to fit the whole. So this might be relevant when you're doing a questionnaire. You might pick 10 items that are going to be useful, and you can measure how well they cohere with each other. So if they cohere very well, then you may have a valid measure. Then another area that is sometimes neglected is criterion-related validity. A lot of people look at whether two measures converge, whether two measures that purport to measure depression, for example, are related to each other. If they are related to each other, then you have two measures that may be tapping into the same construct. However, if they're unrelated, in a place that we have divergent validity, then essentially we have divergent validity. So people often tend to look at convergent validity. They want to check to make sure their new scale fits with the old scales, but they sometimes forget that it's also important to find scales that don't measure something like depression to make sure that they're tapping into really what they want to tap into. So let's go back to the targets. So we said that you can have a valid measure if you're hitting that target. So in the first column, you can have a valid measure by hitting the target every time, or you can have a valid measure by having an average of items that hit that target. You have an unreliable measure as the balls spread out from the center or from any place. So as you can see in the balls in the center, that's going to be a reliable, valid measure. On the right, at the top, you have a reliable measure that's not valid. You never hit the target here. And in fact, at the bottom on the right, you have an unreliable, invalid measure because you just have a random spread of balls all over the place. To summarize, having validity means you're measuring what you want to measure. Measures can be reliable, but not valid. When two measures examining the same construct are highly related, you likely have convergent validity. A couple questions to take away that you might use for organizing your notes might be, does validity mean that you measure the construct you want to measure? And when two measures examining the same construct, should they be related to each other? Thank you for listening today. If you have any questions or concerns, please contact the program coordinator. Thank you.